Hello, and welcome back to Bite-Sized Neo4j for Data Scientists. This is part 18 in our series, and today we're going to put it all together as one nice end-of-year gift. So today we're going to use graph embeddings that we talked about last time to create a machine learning model. My name is Claire Sullivan. I'm a data science advocate at Neo4j, and here's how to find me on the internet. Now, before we start, we are going to go over our usual links. The first is how to create a sandbox instance for free. The second is all of the videos in this series. And the last one is the repository, which will be very important for today. I just want to remind you of an article that will also be important for today if you want more information. And this is an article I wrote about how to use FastRP embeddings within a machine learning model. It goes into more depth than we're going to do today. But let's get started. I am going to create a blank sandbox instance. And today, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go to the repository. And in particular, there is in the notebooks directory, part 18. And this is what we're going to be using today to create our machine learning model. All of this stuff up front is just how to connect to my database. We've seen this stuff before. I'm also populating my database. In particular, today we're going to use the Cora dataset. What Cora is looking at which papers cite with which other papers in certain machine learning journals. So like this is our graph model. It's super simple, monopartite graph. I have a paper that goes and cites another paper. Okay, cool. Let's go back to our notebook. So these next cells, all they're doing is populating the database based on some CSV files I have in a GitHub repository. Okay, so what I wind up with when I do that is 2,708 nodes and 5,429 relationships. So we're going to create some graph embeddings, and as usual, we have to create an in-memory graph to do so. It's a pretty simple one. Okay, now we're going to create some graph embeddings, and we did this in the last video, so if you're wanting more information about what these different hyperparameters mean, go check that out. And then the other function that I've created here, we're going to just be using a simple scikit-learn model. It's going to just be a support vector classifier. In this case, we have seven different classes for our data representing different subdisciplines of machine learning. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to create a data frame where I look at, my mouse is not cooperating. I'm just going to grab the embeddings and the subject. The subject is just an integer 0 through 7, 0 through 6. And I'm going to grab a data frame of that data. I'm going to create a column that's called target, which basically is just turning my class into a number that NumPy will like. And I'm just creating those XY variables like we are familiar with in scikit-learn. So that's all those functions are doing. And then I'm going to create a model. I'm going to use five-fold validation. I'm going to create a train test split where I have my test size is 25%. And then I just have a very simple support vector classifier. There's nothing magic about this. We're just going to use that. We're going to fit our training data. We're going to predict off of our test data. And we're going to determine our accuracy. That's all there is to this. So let's give that, let's load that into memory. And I am going to, in this case, create a 256 dimensional vector. This is a graph vector. I'm using just normal FastRP. I'm not doing anything sophisticated here. Just a really simple embedding. And here we get our confusion matrix. And you can see that I have a mean accuracy of 85%. If you go and look into this data set a bit more, what you'll find out is that there's some pretty significant class imbalance here. And so the fact that we're getting 85% is pretty good. If you look at other analyses of the Cora data set, you will find that they get accuracies that are much lower using word vectors, like, you know, in the mid 70s. So if you go into that paper, let me bring the link back up. Go into this blog post here and you'll get more information on how we did all of that. I just want to say thank you not only for today but for tuning in for this entire series. We are going to get back to basics after the start of the next calendar year and just return to some of the whys and hows. So this is kind of the end of our calendar year. Happy New Year to everyone. And if you have any suggestions for things you'd like to see in future videos, please reach out. Thank you, and I'll talk to you in the new year.